Pyramid Times. Myself, Veena Saru, VP at Pyramid Times. And we have wonderful guest with us, Aradhana Tiwari. Aradhana Tiwari worked for many years in international business marketing, followed by 12 years in media and broadcasting. Despite enjoying her time in these roles, she was always looking for something more, a purpose that brought her joy. Upon discovering Access Consciousness, she has experienced a whole new way of living and now shares it with people from across the globe. She is a relationship counselor and also a facilitator for a number of classes, including Being You and Talk to the Entities. She is the founder of the Be the Change, started in early 2018, which is a community of 1,000 plus people from all over the world. She facilitates change, the purpose of which is to create a world of consciousness and oneness, and is designed to empower you to create the life you desire. With this, I welcome Aradhana Tiwari to Pyramid Times Show. Welcome, Aradhana.
Hello.
Welcome, Aradhana.
Hello. Thank you for inviting me to this space, Veena. Thank you so much.
Yeah, we are waiting to hear from you what exactly is of Access Consciousness and how has been your journey with Access Consciousness.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you for asking. I think it's the most beautiful part of my life, how I got into Access. As you started with me with the media background, I have been a girl of my own and I've always lived in my happy, peaceful world. And I think I was a girl who always partied, had fun, holidays. And growing up from a small village, and, you know, everything I desired, I created in my life. Just by looking at it, just been asking for it. And then I was like, I don't want to be, if I'm part of that whole oneness, why would I have to do all the meditation? Why do I have to sit for 3 hours and do the meditation and do something to receive, be the God or be with the God? So, and yet at the same time, I was having fun in life. I was gifted by universe, everything. So, but had a quest, is it that I'm here only on the planet to party, to have holidays and fun and joyful, because everybody around me did not seem so happy. So people were like, what is the purpose of your life? Are you here only to party all the time? I said, yeah, I guess that is it, to meet people and meet the world. But yeah, then I kind of, you know, because we had a broadcasting channel around all these spirituality and stuff. So I luckily got fortunate to meet a lot of spiritual leaders and gurus. I still didn't. And I used to ask them that, you know, why is people sad? Why are people sad? Why are half people sad? Why are they not, you know, this is, everybody has their own journey. So don't judge them by their journey. So I said, okay. So, you know, out of curiosity, I would like to, okay, what is past life? What are these things? And wanted to know more about life. And was doing private sessions with most of them. But I could never kind of get into any modality because I was like, I can't follow anybody. I am my own. I do not want to follow any guru. So I only followed Guru Nanak Ji. Didn't even follow him. He's my friend. So that is the only photograph I have grown up with because my granddad was, he adopted Sikhism. So I'd grown up with him. So and while growing, so I had a friend who actually came across with me to about Access because she used to come to do feng shui in my house. So she mentioned me about this Access thing. And I was laughing. I said, no, I am not interested in any modality. I don't believe into all this. I'm happy in my own world. So she says, no, this is very your type. You know, you don't have to do anything. And so I said, okay. So she wanted to run my bars for the first time. I didn't understand what bars is. Bars is the 32 points in Access where you touch your head and you can be like a walking, talking meditation. You can dissipate a lot what you do it in your meditation. So she said, I will be charging money for it. And that was very weird for my world that, hey, why do you want to charge money? Spiritualism doesn't take money. You're doing good work. You can't take money from me. And she's like, why? You know, it is no spiritualism. This is about just your being, you have to know. And I mean, don't you go to a spa or something? I said, okay, forget it. You take money, but do it today. She says, okay, I'll do it today. So we had lunch and she ran my bars. When she ran my bars for the first time, when she touched my, there are points in my feet, when she went to my feet and she touched my feet, I was like, something moved in my body. There was a electric current or whatever. And I'm like, is that what people call energy? And that is for the first time I was introduced to the word energy, because I had been hearing energy with, from my family, with everybody. I had been doing these courses and classes. And I used to laugh. I'm a doctor's daughter. I used to laugh. I was like, why will I suffer all this energy work? Don't eat medicine. Now body's releasing, now body's getting. And, you know, this entity talking to me, that entity talking to me. I used to laugh. I was like, bullshit, nothing happens. So this is funny. So that is how, that was my first introduction to the word energy. I said, okay, maybe this is called energy. So, but then when she went away, my friend went away, I felt very nice. I felt very spaced. It was like, I just wanted to go sleep. And, you know, I was so quiet in my head. I didn't know I was quiet in my head, but I felt it was very sleepy. So I liked it. And she used to give me certain questions. How does it get any better? What else is possible? Those are core questions from Access, which I did not know. So I used to do it like a parrot reading in the morning. Okay, I have to read this question. I have to do this. And then I asked her that I want to get my bars run. How many times should I get run for anything to get rid of? She says, as many times you want. You can do it every day. I said, I pay you every day so much of money. She says, yeah. I said, oh, no, that is too much money. Every day giving you 5,000 at that time. I was like, that's too much of money. And though I had enough money, still I was like very miser to give her more. So I was like, okay, come once a week. We'll run once a week. So she started coming every week and I started following the questions. And then I was like curious. I said, I should know more about it. Then I went online and searched about Access Consciousness. And in that, I had this Dr. Dane Heed I saw for the first time. I could not search it. I asked her the address and she gave me, and I went online and I saw Dr. Dane Heed talking about his tour of consciousness, his tools. And I started listening to him. I had this habit. I still have a habit. If I follow somebody, then I get glued to them. So I would watch all his videos and, you know, I said, oh, okay, that is what he's saying. Okay, I'll go on when I'm traveling today. I'll see, I'll work out these tools. So I used to be on the red light and that if too much of traffic, I would say, what else is possible? How does it get any better? And I was like, these things won't work. And the traffic used to move. And I was like, oh, traffic moved. I was like, that had to move. It was not just like it happened. I'm like, doesn't life is not, can't be so one line and it moves. But then it was, the magic was, Veena, for every time I did that, things used to move. And I'm like, no, something definitely moves when I use these lines. Started noticing, then there were a lot of court cases going in the family. Then, you know, people would say, no, no, either this or that. And I'm like, okay, what magic is possible here that I'm not aware of? And I would keep, you know, just keep repeating that line, no meaning, nothing. And the magic used to happen. Something else used to show up that I was like, wow, this is working. Then I wanted to meet Dr. Dane. I was like, wow. You know, when I saw him, I was like, wow, such a handsome man. I haven't seen men in ages. Like, you know, I used to only have men as my friends after my marriage for 20, 25 years. I did not even blinked in my eye to a man. So I was like, oh, have I lost that? And then I was like, okay, I should, you know, I have to meet this guy. And my son and my husband would say, are you in love with this guy? I said, I don't know what love means. Everybody started saying that. I say, I have to meet this person for sure in one day, because after every this, Dr. Dane used to say that would meet you in person one day. I said, sure, I'll meet you one day in person. So he was coming to India in 2014 at first time for the ESP, Energy Synthesis of Being, his program. And for that to attend, I had to do the prerequisites of bars and foundation. So I had to ask my friend that you can make me meet him. She tried, she said I could manage or whatever. I said, okay, let me. And she's like, oh, there's too much of studies in Access. I was like, it's forget it. When I could study so much to meet this man, I'll study. Tell me what I have to study. That is how I went for bars and foundation to learn. and then kind of searched. It's a very long story, but anyways, I finally searched foundation and bars, and I did it, and I started enjoying because it was like you and me talking here. Oh, I said, this is fun. This is like no form, no structure. So everything is talkable. It's like a discussion. It's not like following any rule or, you know, following certain techniques to do it. So I started enjoying it. And I actually did foundation and pass to meet Dr. Danir. And in that long process happened and how I finally attended, whatever. But eventually I met Dr. Danir in 2014 in Bombay for the first time, where I was like, wow. And attending that ESV, my whole life totally changed. Though when I sat down and I looked at him, I was like, he's not that great. It's okay. And why did I come? And he's like, everybody loves him. Why should I be here? How a woman talks. And then I was by the end of that third day, my entire life changed. And since then, I have been attending every access class. And I did not become facilitator to become a facilitator. I was very intrigued by what methods they are teaching, what is it. And it is so much of interest to travel the world and meet people and stuff. So that is how I got into access. And now I'm a walking, talking maestro and a facilitator for most of the things. So I used to be a facilitator for most of the topics under access, which probably last year I have cut down now. So, I mean, I can be in every field, yet under the umbrellas, I'm now doing being you, doctor entities and foundation and money classes. Yet there are like, I have been a children facilitator. Facilitator, I have been a right voice facilitator. So yes, I have been into access for almost 7-8 years now.
That's so amazing and very interesting journey. And you would have seen a lot of changes within you. Can you guide us through the changes that you've come
across? I don't even know who I was, Veena. Now I don't even know who I was. But yet I can say that I am purely magical. I am magic. And this confidence of saying this on the screen today that I am magic and I'm magical and I vouch for it is only because it empowered me. It purely empowered me. The tools purely empowered. I worked on them. I built my muscle with it. I would have never been in front of camera. I was running a media broadcasting channel. And to give you an example, I was interviewed on my own channel, on my own camera, my own people standing. And when they brought the camera, I got blank. I could not say a word. I would never face a camera. I was shot for a lot of my, productions, in-house productions. I could not face a camera. I would never think in my deepest being that I'll be facing camera right now. Today, you call me, any minute you will make me stand in front of camera, I'll be there. I'll be in the world, I mean, extempo, I will just pick up and come and talk to you. And I'm not fearful of any camera. I'm not being ashamed of me to be in the world. I'm like, I'm just there. You ask me and I'm there, which is not at all me. I was a shy girl who could never face people, who was always contracted in a world because I'm coming from a village. I had my own thing that, probably I'm not that high up. I'm not that educated, though I had traveled the world. I have lived every luxury, yet I never had that whole confidence. But now it's like, it's only me in the world. I mean, I can change lives. I can change my life. I can create magic for me. If anybody's receiving the magic, I just have to say it's done and it's done.
That's so amazing, listening to you, the life that you are having currently.
It is beautiful. It's just magical. It is, because I always looked for magic, Veena, in my life from my childhood. I used to pick up stones and used to rub on the, pathways, and like maybe a genie will come out and will ask me, what do you need, madam? And that was how I used to wait. And I remember first time I finished my facilitator training, I never went for this, that I have to do it for anybody. I wanted to learn from, facilitate myself. And if I get into any problem, which I was never a problem into. And I went and said to Gary, who's the founder of Access Consciousness, you know what, Gary, today I came to know I am the magic and I've been looking for that genie to come out. I am the genie of my life. And he's like, girl, you got it. You get it when you get it. And I'm so grateful to Gary and Dane for who they be, what they be. And a lot of people in India have this point of view that, you know, Access is all India. This whole everything is in my throes of India and all the Vedas and stuff. I totally get you. It's everywhere the same. But how simplifiedly they have put into world and they're simple to use. You don't have to make anybody your master. You don't have to make anybody your guru. Today, Gary and Dane are not my masters or my gurus. They are as friends as we are. And there's no senior, junior in it. It's just that they, how much you use the tool, how much you practice language, that's how expert you be. So how much you look within, they taught me how to look within, how to be me. I don't have time for the world. I am so busy in my own life. I'm happily, joyfully saying on this platform that I am selfish.
That's so nice. When I approached you, you told we can speak on anything. I was wondering, this is an interesting person. She's so open and receptive of everything. I was even, it's like mind-blowing kind of experience for me. Oh, what kind of person is she?
Oh, wow. Thank you for saying that. Thank you for acknowledging. Yes. For me, we are everything. For me, Veena, it's you also me. I'm yes. You. So I really repeat that line from Maharishi, that person, I forget the name, but I read these lines, there are no others. Somebody asked
how Ramana to... Ramana Maharishi.
Ramana Maharishi, thank you. I keep listening to everybody. I follow what I follow. So it's like and how he was asked how to treat others and he says there are no others. And I totally have experienced that within myself of oneness. And from my childhood, I was like, teacher said it's oneness. So how do you have so many gods? How do you put so many faces of the gods? I used to ask my mother. And then I say, oh, okay, you want to see him as a Ram. You want to see him as a Jesus. It's fine. But God is one. So for me, I've always seen everything as one. Yet, over the journey of my life, I learned to separate that into polarity. And now I'm again teaching one and how to. So I totally get what that is. And you cannot teach what you're not being. And you cannot have what you're not being.
I totally resonate with you that I have been going to a little bit of Scientology stuff and also even landmark education. I have been through, but I never understood what is possibility, But when I came to access even the past class, something striked in me. Maybe yeah. Because of the processes or whatever the tools they handed over to us, they are so amazing.
Yeah, and the simplest tool I would like to give here is about what is this, what can I do? Can I change it? If yes, how? That nobody needs to learn. It is not difficult. And every information that flows to you is just a question away. What is this? Like, what do I do with it? Like, you know, like anything comes to me, I am like, okay, what is this? Like, if a sickness coming in a body is not well, I'm like, hey, what is body? What is this? What are we aware of? And that's simple. And body gives you information and the people come and give you information. You really don't have to study so hard. You don't have to make your life so hard and so intellectual. The best is when you are the dumbest, you are the most intellectual because then you have total control. Like I always said I was dumb. I'm not very intellectual, but I get to get done everything that I require in my life.
That's amazing. And you have also written the book, Be the Change. Can you
yes.
speak more on that concept?
Yes, Be the Change is my very close to my heart. So how after Access, I wanted, I acknowledge that, you know, I always wanted to be asked, what do I know? And I think we all have that question asked, what do you know? Because we have always, since our childhood, been entrained and taught, okay, you know, teacher will teach you, parents will teach you. And I kept waiting. Will anybody ever ask me, Aradhana, what do you know? Nobody asked me, Veena. Nobody. I was like, you know, then you get married, then your husband is telling you, then your in-laws are telling you, the friends you knew it. Okay, no, you're not right. You're not right. You're wrong. I'm like, okay. Then I used to sit alone and think, okay, what I know, How would people know that what I know? Nobody asking me this question, and nobody told me to be it. So when I got into access and when I became a maestro, and I was like, I remember standing there in the 200 people's class, finally telling Dr. Dane, thank you for it. I said, you are the first person who's saying you're a maestro. You know what you know. And go be that gift in the world. I'm like, wow, that melts my world. And I said, I'm really grateful to myself for choosing these classes and courses. I didn't know I'll reach here, but I knew I followed the energy. And when I started this access, Veena, how you, in access, we have clearings, we make questions. Because access is all about question, that you have choice and you question everything. So I always felt that I am not a very intelligent girl, or maybe my vocabulary is not high. I am a very, very simple girl. I will use the simplest English, simplest words. And my sister, on the other hand, is pretty intellectual and you'll very high-end vocabulary and stuff. And I could never, even if I could go through it, I could never learn it. For me, I used to run from the longer words. So when I got into it, I wanted a very short, I am very shy of reading too much. So I did try, like, being, you know, how Europeans and English people are, they would like, okay, your English would become better if you read books. I tried. I did my best. I couldn't, but I could, the only books I would love to read was cookery books. And very lately, then I got into religious, the spiritual books, which were giving insight, like Vedas and all. So I wanted a simplest question. I was like, give me simple tool to follow. And that is when it actually brought me to access. And then I'm like, okay, how to be these tools? So I wanted to have one tool and be with it the whole day. I didn't want to have everything together in one go, you know. That was very claustrophobic. So I thought, you know, maybe like me, somebody will be like me who would also like to have one question and ponder on it. So I started a group called Be the Change. And I knew that everybody knows something special. So I used to put that question, and I when I became a facilitator, everybody knew me because I used to do a lot of swaps. So people, I said, guys, I'm starting this group. So they thought, you know, I'm a facilitator. I would facilitate them. So I would put a question every morning and they would ask me, okay, Radna, so what do you mean by this? And I would say, what do you know? A lot of people used to get frustrated that she's not giving her answer. I said, no, I'm not here to give your answer. I want you to know and figure it out in your world. In fact, yesterday, one of my friends called me and she's like, you've written this. Who said it means sorry? You know, I had these quests. So I wanted to know more around it. So I started this WhatsApp group, which became pretty famous over the period of time. It had built up its own energy. So it built up and it really changed a lot of people's world. And people used to like, I didn't even know who all were on my group. And it like over the years grew up its own. And I had so many followers and people would stand, you know, oh, you are the one, Aradhana Tiwari, who started that Be the Change group. So it's changed my life. And I was like, really? Wow. Just one simple question every morning I put. And at times I do discuss with people if they have. And I put another question in their world. So from there, I got this inspiration. Then it formed a life of its own. It has now Insta, Telegram, Facebook, everything formed its own life and Be the Change. And this Be the Change book showed up, which is a compilation of 100 tools, which is 100 questions, which you actually, if you start reading them and being into them, your entire life shifts. And it's such a magical book. When it's next to me, my body starts tickling. And things change. And anything I'm going through, if I pick up, that question is exactly dot on. So how it showed up was its own journey. I think it is an entity of its own. It's just creating. And now it has a community more than 1,500 people, which is like over the span of how it got created, I wonder. It's just doing its job, because I have given the job to Be the Change, that please invite the world to into it, to change and come share. So I also have a Be the Change talk show on my page of Facebook, where a lot of people come, they share how they have the courage and they never gave up. So from all these inspirations, I got this book, Be the Change. So it is the most, it can be with any age group people from 0 to 100. I think everybody's loving that book, and it's a very easy book to be carried. It's a kind of a workbook. You want to play with it. It has 100 questions and 100 tools to it. And, you know, it's a beautiful gift for people to change if nobody wants to follow anybody. And especially people who say that I'm atheist or I don't believe into all this work, just go keep a book next to them. Probably if they pick it up, they will. And this book has its own energy. And even if they question, what is this, they might start changing.
Yeah, even I have went through your book. It's not like a regular book with lot of text, but it has a lot of pictures. It radiates its own kind of energy.
Yeah, it has. It is beautifully how it came up. And I think how it just called up the graphic artist, my editor and me into place. And I remember my editor and my graphic artist who started, they said, oh, this book will be done, like, it hardly take 15 days, you know, it's all is set, you've done the material and we'll do it. It took months for them to get over because they used to go into sleep. They used to get tired and everything used to move. And my graphic artist, they're like, we were like, how to depict these pictures? Because there were two of them, they didn't know because everybody had their own awarenesses to it. It was a beautiful journey. They mentioned we did have it on the Facebook, and they mentioned they were crazy to complete this book. Every question has its own molecules to it. And so many people have got back to me. This is, oh, it's the most amazing book we ever had. Most simplest, but it is so potent. It looks like nothing, but it is so potent. But I always believe the magic comes in small packages. In simplified form, and life is very simple. We are complicating it.
That's so nice, Aradhana, that you have done a wonderful work. Even with or without your presence, the book will do a lot of service.
Yeah, I think it has its own life. I am not doing anything to it, honestly. I'm very truthful to it. And when I facilitate Veena, I don't talk. There are energies which come and talk. There are beings who talk, and it's just the universe that talks. And at times I get so fascinated, how did I say this? So, you know, I have surrendered totally as Aradhana. It's only whatever consciousness needs to speak, it comes and flows through me. So that is a big, huge change in my life from Access journey of 8 years. I am not the one who's doing anything.
That's so amazing. And what are the courses that you offer?
So I do under the umbrella of Access. I do foundation. I do their money workbooks. I do talk to entities. I do being you classes. And initially I have done Right Voice and Conscious Parents, Conscious Kids. So I do private sessions for all of them, Right Body and everything. But now as a facilitator with the certification, and I've been a relationship coach for like quite a lot of many years. So these are all courses I've run, and now I have started with the Be the Change program, so which is an entity of its own, which has a space from no form, no structure, no significance. So that is, we are starting the Taste Your program on the 17th, which is like, it will be a year-long program where people can join for 3 months, 6 months, and a year if they want to become the facilitators. And in whatever, if the person is a home lady, housemaker, how she is facilitating change, how can she facilitate change in other people and bring the gift in them out? So art of facilitation. So it's kind of a Be the Change program, which is starting from March 2021. So we are laying down foundation, and we have a taster program coming from 17th to 20th, 3 hours class, 3 to 4 hours. And which will give you the taste of what is going to be that in the year-long program with every topic, where I will be guiding everybody from step to step, how to facilitate and how, what signals, like person like me who did not know energy. I'm a pure energy person, and I have been psychic from my childhood, which I never knew before that. And how to bring that capacity wherever, either you're at home, either you're in a corporate world, either you're whatever. So how can you facilitate and be the change and invite people to be the change? So that is another program that is starting with me. And they will be a certified facilitators, and Be the Change will take the responsibility to take them along around the world and introduce and market them.
That's so amazing, wonderful work you have been doing. Looking forward to see more of your programs spread across the world. And definitely being in the presence of an Access certified facilitator, it's not like a usual life that we live day in and day out. It would be same life in general, normal person's life. But being with a Access facilitator, your life will be transforming. You can choose whatever you want or you have been waiting for.
Exactly. I think it's not about even Access facilitators. It's about the change you be. This is the quickest way to change your world. This is and you know it all. It's just that, you know, you haven't acknowledged. So if you really want to be the gift and you have been looking and you have been tired of who you be, what are you here for? This is the easiest way you can be. And be joyful. People ask me, what do? I said, I spread joy and happiness and I empower you to be joyful. My work is I be the magic and I empower you to be the magic and to be the joy you be. You're not here to work. You're not here to cry on this planet. You're here to be joyful. And when you're joyful, everything follows. Money, magic, flamboyancy, luxury, everything flows to you.
That's so amazing. And what are your future targets for next 5 years?
So my future targets is definitely making Be the Change go around the world. And whatever consciousness contributes, I'm willing. My always is be happy, be joyful, and invite the whole world to be that joyful.
That's so amazing. And when I first saw you, I feel connection with even Shana Nohara.
Yeah. thank you.
You both are looking similar.
A lot of people say me that now, that, you know, you and Shana Nohara have so much of a similar energy. And I've always been very fascinated by her. My three, four people in Access, what was Dr. Dani, Shana Nohara, and there was a Blossom lady who has no more into Access. But these three people pulled me into Access. And yeah, I think Shannon knows what she talks and I know what I talk. So
that's
thank
so
you.
Amazing.
For
thank
you.
Yeah. And what kind of future do you see in India related to spreading of Access consciousness work? Maybe to the towns and also to the local rural areas.
It's huge. It's like that, you know, that is when I actually want to invite Be the Change page as Be the Change program for people in India to rise up and then take the tools of Access to rural India in their language. What I generally see with people is people want to follow one rag, but then learn the tools, be the tools and go to the rural areas in the world and, you know, be that energy, be that gift. And I think India, everybody is very aware. It's just that we have to go knock their doors. So how can I bring up that change in the world with Be the Change so that I can give them give these tools in simplified forms in their language, in their spaces, in their areas, and they grow from there. So I see it's huge. It's coming up and I'm thanks for telling me that. And actually thanks for inviting me. That just stuck to me while talking to you that actually, what will it take for me to take it to the rural India? Because I am from a rural India. I'm from a village and I've grown up. In fact, I came back from my hometown and it has contributed me so much. And what else is possible for me to take all the tools of Access to rural India? Let's see what I've asked it right now in front of me and what else is possible. I'm willing to go take it and ask people to take it along with them.
That's so amazing. It's wonderful for all the great work you have been doing.
Yeah, and I'm sure people like you will be there. Like today you invited me for that and you reminded me of that. And I'm like, okay, there I go. And there will be people who will take me and show me the way and I am ready to go.
That's so amazing. Can you also speak a little bit more on the work of the entities? Because I have been hearing about you that you do a very excellent work in terms of entities.
Yeah, it's so funny. Like I remember when last Shannon was in India, she actually acknowledged that about me. And she's like, I was telling my husband, when I see Aradhana in different classes, it's different. But when I see Aradhana for the entities class, she is way happier. She is like so different. There is something she knows special. I'm like, I wonder what I know special. Yet, but I have always said that entities are my better friend. I am not scared of entities. I'm more scared of people. And from my childhood, I was never scared of the ghosts or the spirits. I was more scared that a man would come with a knife or hit me. I was like, I can manage my other friends, but I can't manage these humans. So I have been mentioning this to my friend last 2 days, and I'm like, I'm not from this world, guys. I don't get you guys, what you do. I am from a very different world, and my world is very different. And I think I am from that entity world. I do get that I have a body, and they're beautiful. Like, I have another class tomorrow, which is the introduction class for talk to entities, and other people have invited me. I think I have a back-to-back 3 sessions. People have invited me to talk about entities, which is so funny. And it's like, I just feel they're so amazingly kind, gentle, and they just want attention. So today, if I leave my body, Veena, I am not going to be more smarter than what I am today. Probably I might just want to say hi to Veena. But Veena doesn't know, because Veena's already made up that the body is gone, that you can't connect. But is that true? Right now I'm sitting here, I can connect to my son or my family. You're sitting here, but if I ask you to think about your mom, which you already were, so if you go right now, think about your mom, you are already connected, right? So if you can be connected sitting here with your mom, why is it that once she leaves the body, you can't be connected to her? So whatever you want to send her, you just say it, right? So they are as simple, and they are just wanting your attention. But it is a lot of fun to have their attention. They really contribute. They are not from this selfish world of killing you or whatever. Yes, because they want to be known. They want to be understood. So they do come and take your bodies and charge of your bodies. But they only take your body's charge when you give them. So they are very, very disciplined. They're more disciplined than humans are. So, you know, they're very easy. You bring them up, they help you out with so many things. They gift you so much. They give you so much of information. So these workshops are amazing. And our judgments are the entities that we hold the most. And when our judgments become very, very strong, they become demons. So nobody is more demon than you to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So there is nothing to get scared of entities ever. Trust me, you really are. I was telling to another colleague of me right now, I said, you guys come to my class and we'll have fun. I have always said the class, and we have been laughing and fun and joy. And after that, I think everybody's lives have changed. Entities, a lot of fun. They're not scary. And even my phone is an entity right now. My book with Be the Change Which Came is an entity of itself, but it doesn't have a body, right, Veena? But it talks to me.
Yes.
If I'm not scared of that, why am I scared of people? So there is nothing to be scared of. These all visuals are man-made. Your visualization.
Yes.
So there's nothing to be scared of. In fact,
we look at our own body and feel we are like a finite beings, but we have access to everything in the infinite nature of us. As you are saying, you connect to the oneness a lot, and everything is available there, and we are not separate from anything.
And everybody is my face, right? Even the scariest face is my, because I am the source of creating it.
Right.
In oneness, I'm only one. I'm only giving those faces and structures and those energies form and structure. So I am the only demon, or I am the only entity. Who are you scared of?
That's so nice.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Aradhana, for giving a wonderful knowledge of access consciousness and how it is able to create change, and going forward, how you are contributing to taking it to large masses of people. We are definitely looking for that. And thank you so much for coming to the Me Time Show. Yeah, and all the links related to Aradhana's work around her website, the book link and the FB group will be provided below this video. Please go and check out. Yeah.
Thank you,
Aradhana. Take care. Yeah, bye.